Hi, my name is Tom Pollard. I am a filmmaker and a mountain climber, adventurer, and a friend of mine who is a teacher for an elementary and middle school has asked me if I would talk about what it's like to climb Mount Everest on the north side, the Tibetan side, from China, because she is currently reading a book by Jordan Romero, who became the youngest person ever to climb Mount Everest at 13 years of age. And so it has become quite a talk of the class to know a little bit more about the mountain, and I'm going to share that with you. So I fell in love with mountain climbing when I was an adult. I was in my 20s, and right from the very beginning, when I learned how to climb, I, of course, set my sights on the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. It was my dream, my life dream, to go there someday. In 1999, I got that opportunity. I also returned there in 2019. So my experience on the north in Tibet spans 20 years. For those of you who might not know, Tibet is right where this arrow is, and the arrow points directly down to where Mount Everest. It's on the border of a country named Nepal and Tibet, which is part of China. When you climb Mount Everest from the north, some teams might fly to Lhasa, which is the capital of Tibet. But in 2019, we went to Kathmandu first, and the Kingdom of Nepal. Kathmandu is the launching point for us, so we gathered all our things, got the team together, went on some trips around the city to visit the beautiful stupas. This is called Bodhnath Stupa. It's the largest stupa in the world and a very beautiful place that one must visit if they want to see the culture and the intrigue of the Kingdom of Nepal. So we literally get into SUVs, these four-wheel drive vehicles, and we drive all the way north across the border into Tibet in order to reach the base camp of Mount Everest. In Tibet, this is a village called Tingri. This is Mount Everest off in the distance behind a monastery in Tingri. And continuing along the drive, we get to the gates of Chomalungma National Nature Reserve, and we slowly make our way, literally driving right to base camp. Base camp is a very beautiful place. You can see that we set up our tents in the shadow of Mount Everest. That's it, off in the background. Our team gathers and we keep warm and eat and do all our team meetings here in these big tents that they set up. I want to add, as we move into these beautiful photographs, that on this expedition, I had to check out after reaching the North Col, and in 1999, unfortunately, did not even have a summit bid. I did go to high camp at 27,000 feet. You'll have to look for a future video of mine that shows my summit day on the south side. I've been to two expeditions on the south side, two on the north. My one and only summit day came in 2016. So here is the shot of the north face of Everest, and I'll show you a little bit. This is how we climb up. If you follow that dot on the lower left where it says advanced base camp, we basically follow that up. It takes us many, many weeks of work to get there. And without the hard work of the cooks, these people cook for us three meals a day, usually prepare a lunch for us in advance and feed not only us, but these wonderful Sherpa who were our brothers and sisters on the expedition. And we move our way up toward advanced base camp along the Rongbuk and the East Rongbuk Glacier. As you can see, we're nearing Everest itself. And then we get to advanced base camp at 21,000 feet in elevation. And this is what our tents look like. In the upper right corner, you can see where we're going. We're going up toward what's called the North Col. It's a wall of ice, very, very steep, and we have to climb straight up that. You can see the lone figures kind of angling up from the lower left. So this is what the North Col looks like, 23,000 feet in elevation. Absolutely beautiful place to be. Most of the people leave for the upper reaches of the mountain before it gets light out during the day. And so this is what it looks like to go up higher. And now there's a climber affixing himself to a fixed rope, going up that rope just in case wind might knock him over. And now we're climbing with oxygen, and that's Renan Ozturk, an immensely talented filmmaker who took a lot of the pictures that you're looking at too. And then you can see climbers slowly making their way up the mountain toward what's known as Camp 2. Camp 2 is at about 25,500 feet into a place called the Death Zone, where your body is literally dying. There's nothing you can do to get stronger. You can't sleep enough, eat enough, drink enough. Your body is dying bit by bit. And so we make our way up to Camp 2, and you can see the beautiful views back in the distance. Now now we need to move up to Camp 3, which is at about 27,000 feet in elevation, and that's the launching pad for summit day, and all the climbers leave before it gets light out. You need to get up and back down as quickly as possible. It's so dangerous up there if bad weather comes in. So the idea is, if the weather is good, leave under headlamps and climb up. And the cool part is sunrises down here at sea level are beautiful, but sunrises high up on a mountain are absolutely breathtakingly spectacular. So the team had to go and climb up on this. On the left is what's called the second step, the most technically difficult part of the hike or the climb to the summit of Mount Everest, which is 29,035 feet. And they're looking up toward the summit. The headlamp's still on. There's Mark Synnott making his way up to what's called the third step. And here are the climbers making their way up the final bit of climbing up to the summit. Absolutely spectacular. And now here are the climbers on the summit of Mount Everest, the highest point on the planet. A little bit of celebration, but the summit, as fun as it is and as beautiful as it is, all the climbers know that the only way to count that as a successful summit is to get back down safely. The thing about climbing mountains is that it takes a lot of sacrifice, and a lot of people are like, why would you do something that is so dangerous? Because people die when they do this, and it's true. But for me personally, it's about I loved it so much, and I still do, that I was willing to sacrifice things. I was willing to go the extra mile in order to achieve my dream. And as a student who is watching this short film, if there's something you love, then go after it. Get good grades if you can, and finish school and everything. But nobody, no friend of yours would ever tell you that what you dream to do is dumb, because those aren't your friends. The people you want around you are the people who want the best for you. They want to help you achieve your dreams and goals. So dream. Dreams are free. You can do whatever you want, no matter how hard your life is or no matter how impossible it seems that you might someday be able to climb Mount Everest. You can do it. You can go after it and just hang in there and dream and be good and kind to others and train for it. Study, research, do the things that you need to do to know as much as possible about what it is that you love to do. And that opportunity will find you someday. So thanks for listening to me today. You can look in the liner notes of this YouTube video, and you'll see a way that you can reach out to me to find my podcast or the social media of all the people who were involved in this expedition. Thanks very much. May you achieve your greatest dreams. And if you do, let me know, because I'll be the first one to cheer you on. Thanks a lot, and have a great day, guys.